Hey folks, David Thomas Tao, and today I'm reviewing an exciting limited edition bottle from High West, the Prisoner's Share. This is a blend of straight bourbon and rye whiskeys finished in the Prisoner Blend wine barrels. Now, why is that? Well, I will give you a little bit of insight. Both High West and the Prisoner Wine Company are owned by Constellation Brands, so the same parent company. So of course the collaboration makes sense, but we're actually going to judge it not on the merit of its business acumen as a bottle, but on the flavor. But before we get into that, make sure you subscribe to Vine Pair on youtube.com. You're already on there. Please do it for me. I will feel better about myself. Okay, the Prisoner's Share. 102 proof blend of straight bourbon and rye finished in wine barrels. Now, if you're a fan of High West, and I've been a fan of High West for a long time, you're no stranger to them finishing things in other things, finishing whiskeys in other types of casks. A Midwinter Night's Dram, which we have reviewed on this very YouTube channel, the most recent version. That's a blend of straight rye whiskeys finished in port barrels. This is a blend of bourbon and rye. So it's not just rye, it's not just bourbon, it's a blend of straight bourbon and straight rye finished in the Prisoner Red Blend wine barrel. So it is different. High West has a lot of experience finishing stuff in different types of casks. They do it for some of their releases for like the double rye. They'll finish in all sorts of types of casks like Armagnac. They finished light whiskey in Armagnac. Really like that distillery, only released a couple years ago. Brendan Coyle is their master distiller. Really respect a lot of the work he's done over the years. Met him briefly about a year ago. So I'm excited to try this. This was released in 2022. This batch in 2023. Looks to probably be the final batch of this being released, at least in this version. It comes in a really interesting bottle. And this little like hang tag was actually the pull tab to get around the wax. Kind of interesting. We're gonna try it out. Let's pour it. Boop. I love High West corks. I love their corks. I love their corks. Love them. Anyway, let that sit for a second. Like a lot of High West products finished in wine barrels, that is dark. That is like a, man, that is like a ruby red slipper right there. We're going back to Kansas, Toto. Okay, red fruit, red fruit. I keep saying red fruit over and over because I'm getting red fruit, guys. Cherry, strawberry, raspberry. I could keep going, but I'll run out of red fruits eventually. This is crazy. For a brief second, it smells a little bit like cherry herring, the cherry liqueur. And then the rye spice, the spice from the whiskey, I'm assuming more rye spice, kind of comes in. And actually, at first it noses so fruit forward, it's so cherry, right? And then it starts to be more reminiscent of something like a Midwinter Night's Dram from High West, where you get the spice and you get the underlying whiskey, you get the spirit. Interestingly, this has bourbon in the blend. It's not just rye. The second phase does remind me of a Midwinter Night's Dram. I get the spice, rye, baking spices. And then there's like a bit of a cooling sensation, a little bit of menthol, some spearmint, wintergreen maybe, and some herbal notes. The herbal notes do remind me of rye from MGP, the 95.5 mash bill, which High West has sourced for many years and includes in a lot of their blends. We don't know the exact percentages of the bourbon and rye used in this blend. High West always guards those, closely guarded trade secrets. I like this, the nose is a narrative here. The nose is a narrative from fruit to spice to some like cooling elements and herbal notes. There's a story here. There's a story on the nose. It's fun. I like storytelling. Of course, if you want my full notes on the nose, the palate, and the finish, three components of flavor and taste, make sure you read my full review at the link in the description below where I nerd the heck out. Let's sip. One for show, two for go when it comes to sips. Okay, different fruit than on the nose. Apricot, plum, pear on the mouth. On the nose, it was red fruits, but yeah, apricot and plum. On the palate there, ooh, I like that. That's dark, dark fruits, really dark fruits there. That fruit fades to like, not a caramel sweetness, honestly, maybe like a confectioner sugar, just standard sugar sweetness. By the mid palate, black pepper. There's black pepper on this. I'm not a wine guy. I like wine, but I am not like the wine expert. That's what we have Keith at Vine Pair for. Keith is like the guy. He's like the dude. He's my wine person. So take this with a big grain of salt, but that black pepper element reminds me of a black pepper element I get from a lot of really flavor-forward red wines. Keith, I'm not stepping on your toes here. You are the wine guru, but I've been watching your videos. I've been reading your articles. I'm gonna borrow some notes. Black pepper. I think it comes from the wine. And then spice kind of comes on starting at the mid palate, moving to the back of the palate, the sides of the palate, the top. And the spice kind of builds cinnamon, cumin, nutmeg. Cumin's interesting. I get that cumin with the black pepper. Okay, the progression on the mouth is actually really interesting. It goes from like wine at the tip of the tongue to like bourbon sweetness on the mid palate, and then on the back palate, the sides of the mouth, rye spice, which is really interesting. There is a narrative on the nose and there's a story here on the mouth, and I'm getting all of the components here. I'm getting the two whiskeys and the wine, but wine, bourbon, rye. Wine, bourbon, rye. Kind of interesting. Wine, bourbon, rye. I can say that all day. That rye spice and the bourbon sweetness on the palate really made my mouth water. Like, I'm swallowing a lot because my mouth is watering, but the finish actually gets a little drier and zesty. The finish leans zesty and citrusy, which is really interesting. Quite liked it. Okay. The Prisoner Share from High West, that blend of straight rye and bourbon whiskeys, finished in the Prisoner Red Blend wine barrels. The Prisoner Red Blend wine barrels. That is difficult to say. I really enjoy this. I'm trying to remember what I thought about the first release in 2022. I think I like this one a little bit better, the 2023 release. I'm giving this 93 points. This is different. This is different than a Midwinter Nice Dram. That's what I was a little worried about. And I've talked to people who haven't tried this, but they do like High West, and they're like, isn't it just gonna be the same thing as a Midwinter Nights Dram? I definitely get something different here. I get different elements. They're like cousins, but maybe they're not quite siblings. Really enjoyed this, 93 points. Not sure if they're gonna be releasing more collabs with The Prisoner moving forward. I would like if they did, and I would like for them to try new things on this. So 93 points, a really tasty pour with some interesting elements. It's different. It took a big swing and at least got a double, maybe a triple. But I wanna know, have you tried any High West products you love? Have you tried any High West products that let you down just a little bit? Let me know in the comments below. I'll give my thoughts. I have been drinking High West for a long time. It's always cool to see them doing new things. This definitely qualifies as a new swing and a twist on a classic. Let's put it that way, a twist on a classic. But for vinepair.com, I'm David Thomas Tao. Cheers to that. Enjoy the weekend. I don't know what day you're watching this, but just enjoy whatever upcoming weekend you have.